Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching ForuTech. In the last video we reviewed the OxygenOS 15v400 update for OnePlus 12. From that I am using the v400 build with the software OTA version v20p01, but as I already mentioned in our 2 days before video, the new OxygenOS 15 incremental SOTA version v30p01 update will be available for all OnePlus devices. So yesterday I got the new OxygenOS V500 update via OxygenOS OTA Updater application. It has small changelog, but the update size was big. It's about 1 GB, and in a stock OxygenOS OTA section I got another small update of software OTA version V30P01, and its size was 343 MB. Today we are going to install and we'll do the combined update review of both the updates. We also shown some missing features of this update which are mentioned in the changelog but not found in the phone, along with the new OxygenOS launcher that we reviewed in our old video. So watch this video till the end. Now with the further delay, let's get started. First, I downloaded and installed the new OxygenOS V500 update via OxygenOS Updater application. After updating to the V500, now I got only small 23 MB of new SOTA version update V30P01. So if you got the V30P01 in a stock OTA updater, you can install that first, then you can download and install another V500 update via stock OTA updater or by using the OxygenOS Updater application, as per your wish. So my installation of new updates are finished. Let's check out the version details. OTA section now completely updated and showing the OxygenOS version as V500 with the SOTA version V30P01. Version section is also updated with the same OTA version with the SOTA version as V30P01 PRB1EX01. Everything is up to date, so let's check out the new changes and the features of this update. First change as per the V500 update is we got the new tap to share feature for iPhone sharing setting. Now you can share your OnePlus device content with the iPhone with just one tap. For this you need to enable the NFC on your device and your iPhone must have the OnePlus Connect application installed. If your iPhone didn't have that, so you can scan this code and can install that application on your iPhone. In the QS panel, OnePlus added the iPhone share tile. You can toggle on it and can share anything anytime with just one tap using the NFC feature. Next features we already shown in our older video with my OnePlus 9RT device, but still we will check them on OnePlus 12R. We can now zoom in or out in the OnePlus Photos cover photo album. We can set the proper view of the cover page of the photo album using zoom in or out feature. New smart tag now efficiently categorize all your photos like people, screenshot, places, electronics, and it's pretty accurate. Next, now we can overview the weather widgets on the home screen without adding the city or the location in a widget setting. Once you confirm the view of widget, later you can set the other setting. If you don't like the screenshot floating window notification, then under the screenshot setting, we get the new toggle to disable or enable the new screenshot preview floating window. So you can disable this notification if you didn't want this floating notification. I also got two different toggles which are not mentioned in the changelog. One is to delete the original screenshot if you edit the original screenshot using the edit option. Next is if you want the screenshot of the display for just purpose of extraction, you don't want to save that screenshot, then you can use this toggle. You didn't need to manually delete such screenshot which you taken just for the sake of content extraction. Next is the new body font editing feature for the Notes application. OnePlus Notes app now supports the font control for the body text. You can set the size of body font text to the different setting. Next are some security settings. Some of them are missing that we will check at the end of this video. First one is if the virus can detect any threat in your device, you can directly select and clear those mentioned malicious application directly within this setting without need of manual uninstallation of such applications separately. Next is we got some new privacy protections for some system functions like screen recording. We can enable this privacy protection toggle, so if you get any notification while taking the screen recordings of your device, they will be not displayed in the recording. So these are all the changes I found. Now let's check out the performance and the stability of this update. OnePlus 12R is already power packet device, so you will not able to detect the performance improvement of this update just when it rides. Everything will be feels super fast. But I did the Geekbench test and I got the score of 1063 and 3948 for the single core and multi core respectively without performance mode. And after performance mode enabled, we got the score of 1923 and 5113. Even for the OpenGL graphics API, I got the score of 8340 and 8963. While for the Vulkan API, the scores were 9273 and 9344 with and without performance mode. CPU performance seems a lot more improved with the performance mode as compared to the performance mode offsetting. Now let's check out what are the missing features that are mentioned in the changelog, but I didn't found that in OnePlus 12R. First one is I didn't found the phone manager setting like app clean feature, which adds the app reset and the app uninstall features. One more feature is that is available for the IR remote, where you can now able to add the photos of your remote application and it will be automatically added to your device list, which is not available for OnePlus 12R. It's already mentioned in the official community post of OnePlus, mentioning it's only available for the supported models which are running with the OxygenOS 15. So it may be only available for the OnePlus 13 series. The new beacon link application is not available for OnePlus 12R, which now helps to call nearby people even if your device didn't have the network signal or the internet connection. It mentioned in the OxygenOS updated changelog for V500 build, but I didn't found it anywhere in the system. This is a pretty cool feature. Hope they will add this in upcoming updates. Next, in the last video, we shown how to install and use the OxygenOS 15 new launcher version V15.6 with its amazing features. That launcher was working perfectly in OnePlus 12R. I thought it will be available by default in the new updates, but new V500 didn't update the launcher version. But you can follow our old video and can install and use the new version of OxygenOS launcher in the new V500 update. You will find the link of that video in the video description. This is all about the new OxygenOS 15 V500 with the SOTA version V30P01. Hope you guys liked our work, then please do like and share this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon for the notifications of our upcoming content on OnePlus 12R and other OnePlus devices running on the OxygenOS. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye bye.